So welcome to the second video of Module 6. The Basal Eurasians, the Who's, the Who Are You. It's gonna come play into this one. So we talked about in the last video about climate change and how that came into play into all of this. So keep this in mind as we start on our journey for this video. I'm going to be focusing on a couple of different studies, and so I'll keep mentioning them as I present data from those different studies. What we're going to be talking about now are results that came out of a paper that was published in 2016 about the ancient DNA from 51 ancient modern humans in this study. And this map gives you a sense of where they're from across Eurasia. And I also just love the way they've done this figure because it points to where the specimens, the individuals, the people are from, the ancient genomes, but it also gives you a sense of time as well. So you can see time then, since you have this geography, and then you have that y-axis that gives you time as well. I just find that visually very pleasing. Gives you a sense of what we're looking at here and where these data are from. So we're going to be focusing now on human population history. So from about 50,000 years ago, going to about 39,000 years ago. When they analyzed those 51 ancient genomes, they found that there looks to be evidence of a population that lived in this Levant region of the world, which you can see here. I've indicated it with this kind of strange cloud figure, which I couldn't come up with something better, so, you know, work with me here. There was a population that lived in this region around that time period, and they call them the Basal Eurasians. It's a population that stems from northeastern Africa, starting at about 50,000 years ago. What we know about the Basal Eurasians from those 51 ancient genomes is that they had no Neanderthal ancestry. So remember that there were Neanderthals, there was this genetic affinity between Neanderthals and people living across Eurasia with the modern genomes, but if you look back in time, the Basal Eurasians, they had no admixture with the Neanderthals or shared genetic affinities because of any common ancestry, or really recent common ancestry. There was a major and distinctive population, the Basal Eurasians, that seems to have had multiple subpopulations that persisted for a long period of time. So this was a pretty major and pretty stable population center for humans between about 50,000 years ago and 39,000 years ago. We don't know exactly who these people were, because they have not yet been able to extract DNA from an old enough skeleton that represented the Basal Eurasians at that time. So we think, based on the genetic sequence data, that they might be closely tied to cultures that lived in North Africa. They would have been genetically isolated from sub-Saharan Africa by the Sahara Desert. And that they then spread into this west part of Western Eurasia. So we don't know, like I said, we don't know who they were. We don't know that really much about their archaeology. Kind of just know that there were this ghost population where we know they existed because they have left traces in these more recent genomes, but we don't actually have evidence of who they were themselves. We think that they may have also given rise over time to a group called the Natufians. And this is a group of people who lived much more recent in time in that region, the Levant, that region of the world. They were around between about 13,000 years ago to about 8,000 years ago. So they're much more recent than the Basal Eurasians, but we think that there may be some relationship, some ancestry descendant relationship between the Basal Eurasians and the people that we now recognize, or we recognize later in time, as the Natufians. And that was at the start of the plant and animal domestication. So now, from that Basal Eurasian population, we know that there were some migrations north out of that. There were there was a population that then diverged as it moved into Peninsular Europe that formed the earliest hunter-gatherers, the ones that coexisted with Neanderthals for some period of time, between 50,000 and 39,000 years ago. And they're a population that derived from the Basal Eurasians, as you can see in that region where I'm showing you them on the map. We also know that there was another major population that migrated out of that Basal Eurasian population north into this more Asian side of the geographic region we're considering. And they formed another population that we refer to as a ghost population. We pick up evidence of their existence from the genetic variation that we find in later people's genomes. So we know that there was this ancient North Eurasian population. And we're going to talk about them quite a bit a little bit later in this module. But we know that this ghost population intertwines the people in Europe with the people who migrated into the Western Hemisphere. So the ancient North Eurasians. So you have the Basal Eurasians and the ancient North Eurasians, two ghost populations. We're going to focus more on that, the Basal Eurasians first and the subsequent populations out of that. And we'll come to the ancient North Eurasians a little bit later. And so now, to take you out, the who. Ooh, we don't want that.